You're watching Distract.
And we are Great, Good, Fine, Okay.
I am joined by these gorgeous gentlemen. How are you guys today?
Very well, thank you.
Doing good. Yeah.
So I want to know, okay, because you guys are getting a lot of exposure. The music is absolutely great. I love everything that you're coming out with. You've been doing this for a while. So when did you guys actually meet?
So it's actually crazy to think about because time just flies. But we're kind of going on our like fifth year of being a band. We met in 2000. Well, we met before 2013, but that's kind of when the band started. And as the story goes, Luke was living around the corner from me in Brooklyn with this guy who was my piano player in my previous band at the time. And so I met Luke just going over there working, and we became friends. And then a couple years later, we decided to collaborate on something and just write a song. And that's what we did. And it kind of started the whole thing.
And what was that first song you guys wrote?
That was You're the One for Me.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice. And so how do you find working with each other? Like, what are your personalities like?
We have very different personalities and very different kind of skill sets and things that we like doing and things that we're good at, which really complement each other. Luke is definitely the producer and the engineer in the relationship, and I'm more of like the emotional kind of lyric writer and come up with a lot of the melodies, and we then go back and forth and, you know, talk about what each other does and work with each other on it. But that's kind of what our relationship's like.
I like it. You're a logical one.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've worked with the Chainsmokers. Tiesto has remixed your tracks. I mean, that's big. Right?
Yeah. I mean, the Chainsmoker thing was cool. That was, it's crazy going back to time flies. That was already about 3 years ago. But they were fans of our work. I think they probably heard You're the One for Me on like Hype Machine.
Yeah.
And reached out to us to see if we wanted to take a stab at top lining the track. And I did it and didn't think much of it. And they hadn't even released Selfie yet. So they weren't like the mega superstars that they are now. And it was just awesome working with them, and after we sent it to them, about a year later, they said they were going to release it as a single, and it came out, and yeah, like it was huge. And it went on from there. I think the song right after was Roses.
Yeah.
So.
Wait, so do you think you might collaborate again?
I don't know.
We would certainly be open to it, yeah. I mean, we're in touch with them, and they're great guys, so anything's possible.
Yeah, because the video was a lot of fun for that. No input from you guys on that?
Yeah, I mean, the video was awesome. We weren't involved.
Okay.
I kind of wish I could have been involved in that threesome situation. Maybe it would have been, you know, a foursome or a...
Or like,
you know,
a you, Alex, Drew kind of thing.
Yeah, just the three guys would have been great.
I mean, I would have loved to have been involved. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people that would have wanted to be involved with that video.
Yeah, I don't know why they didn't invite me. I look great without a shirt on. So, you know, maybe next time.
Chainsmokers, I think we need a redo of that video, please. I would love to be part of it. And do you want to be part of it?
I'm down to just watch.
He's a voyeur.
That's the difference in our personalities. I want to get in there, and Luke's going to take pictures, or, you know.
Guys, going on to Change. That's your single that's been out. It's doing really well. Tell me about that.
I'll start. That was a song that I sort of started writing about a relationship that I was in, a very kind of personal, honest song, and I brought it to Luke about a year ago now. We had rented a house actually in the Catskills, which we like to do. We like to go away to write. We find that it helps us, and that was the first thing I showed him, and he was into it. So we pretty much fleshed that out there, and yeah, it turned into a song that we're both super proud of. So that came out. And then more recently, a couple weeks ago or a few weeks ago, a song called Touch came out, which is kind of like the B-side to Change.
And so the cool thing about these two songs is that there's a two-part music video situation. So the story starts with Change and then continues on into Touch, the next song. So it spans two videos. It's like a little short film.
Yeah, because there was a suitcase, there was a moon, right. And then you stopped. So I'm really excited about seeing this. You guys will see it too.
I guess with Change, you know, he came in with like the melody and actually some chord ideas too on that one, which is pretty rare.
Yeah, which is rare. That's one that I had been like kind of singing in my head.
It was like a piano and like vocal idea. But yeah, I think there's like the main drum sound in like the beginning of it. It's like a little, sounds like a Pringle can or something. It's like the back of a kalimba, which is like a tiny African thumb piano.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Luke is really good at making cool sounds on things you wouldn't expect, which is, you know, one of the reasons why I think our songs sometimes sound really unique and, you know, like ear candy, because it's not traditional kind of sound.
For two weekends in a row, you've kind of been on my sort of like little playlist, and I jump around and I sort of like move around to it, but I think it's also something that can be a sort of dance tune, like that's a mellow sort of dance tune if it's really blasted, right?
Yeah, I mean, there's always like, I feel like all of our music kind of has like that electronic dance kind of element to it. Like a little bit of funkiness maybe.
Yeah.
Definitely the music I like most personally is music that hits you emotionally that you can also dance to. So I think a lot of
for brain and body.
Yes.
I love
heart,
that.
Brain, heart, and body.
Oh. Yeah. See, he's logical. He's brain.
Yeah, he's like, the heart just pumps the blood.
I don't know if that's a third category, but.
In regards to tours, where are you guys touring? Are you going to head over to Europe? Because obviously your music is awesome.
When we first started, we actually took a trip to England and played 6 or 7 shows over there.
Nice.
Maybe I think it was like 3.
I think it was somewhere between 3 and 6. But anyway, we had a great time, and we would love to get back there as soon as possible. And I think plans are in the works too. As far as touring, we just got back from a pretty big tour in the U.S. a couple months ago. We did a co-headline tour with the band Small Pools, and it was like 23 shows in like 30 days, so really intense. And so we probably want to release more music before we tour again in the U.S., but international is, you know, anyone's guess.
Hey,
where are you from?
I'm a Londoner.
Okay.
But, yeah. Like, there's such
We played
good
at
music.
Coco when we were there last.
You were at Coco?
Yeah.
That was my favorite spot.
Super sweet.
In Camden. Mm-hmm. It's so cool.
Yeah.
Oh my God, now
you're
like,
what was the night called? It was like school night or something. It was like some
Thursday
special.
Night?
I think so.
Yeah, you know what? You're now legends. You've played at Coco in London. Like, they're already legends.
We actually released this, like, weird behind the scenes of our trip to London. It's like a 3-part thing that's on YouTube that like no one saw, but if you're curious about our trip to London, you can find those on
crazy
YouTube.
Stuff happen.
I mean, it was just a really crazy busy week that, and we had this guy following us with a camera, so you could see what it was like.
It's festival season now, lots of festivals going on. I mean, did you do any festivals this year? Are you planning on doing any like anytime soon?
Yeah, we just did a couple actually. We did Electric Forest in Michigan, which was amazing.
Yeah.
Both weekends, which was pretty wild.
Oh my God, that's
crazy. Yeah,
that was fun. We played this festival in New York City called Pinknik, which was this rosé festival, which actually funny because when we got offered the gig, I thought for sure it was like a breast cancer awareness festival. So we're like, totally we're in, like absolutely. You know, sign us up. And then I'm like already planning like the speech I'm gonna make about make sure you do self-examinations and this and that. But we get there and it's sponsored by
literally just about rosé.
Just about rosé. Everybody's wearing pink and sitting on like towels with the big bottles of rosé. Yeah. But it was fun. Last year we actually played Bonnaroo,
Which is huge.
Yeah, it was big for us, and we played a festival in San Francisco called Clusterfest, mm-hmm. which was really cool. So yeah, I mean, we love festivals, and you know, hope to play them more next year.
Those outdoor shows are crazy, though. Like, you never know what's gonna happen.
Wait, so give me a story where something went wrong.
Oh, well.
So at this picnic festival.
I wasn't even thinking of that one.
5 minutes before we went on, I got stung in the hand by a bee.
No.
And I play keyboards. So like the whole time, like, you know, I'm just like wringing my hand out and it's like cramping up and I'm just dying. But made it through.
Did you make it look like it was part of the show?
I don't know. I don't know if anyone watching probably was just like, why?
It was pretty like far from where we were to where the crowd was. It was like a barrier with like, I think like pretty far.
You know, it's like a big stage and they're far away, so it probably just looked like I was tweaking out.
If anyone has videos of Luke just going, please send them across.
So the thing I was thinking of is one of the first festivals we ever played was this thing called Capitol Hill Block Party.
Oh, nice.
In Seattle. And we were super pumped. We planned a whole trip on the West Coast just because of this festival. And we get there and none of our stuff works. And it's a quick changeover between bands. We only have like...
I think we had 50 minutes, but we ate up probably 30 minutes just like troubleshooting.
And then it was the first and only time we never got our stuff working. And so, yeah, we ate up most of our time. And then for the last 15 minutes, we just did like sort of like an acoustic performance. Like we did our cover of Prince, which we just did the two of us and like some other things.
Nice.
And it was a huge crowd. And it could have been a total nightmare, but our fans are so great that they were like, into the fact that something terrible is going wrong, like wanted to like be with us in it. So it was like
clapping with you.
Yeah, it was fine. And then the next time we came back to Seattle, people came and like we wanted to redeem ourselves, and I think that that made it even more special.
I still like the bee story better.
Okay, all right. Just... well, 1 point for Luke. 1 point.
Obviously you have Touch out now. And you're going to be producing more music. Have you got anything lined up? Like any collaborations that we should know about?
Well, for the past couple weeks, we've been working nonstop on new songs.
Okay.
It's not a secret that we're planning on releasing an EP in the fall. And all I can say is that the new songs that are going to be, that people haven't heard, are what I think are some of our best stuff. So, nice. And really sort of like show the spectrum of like what we can do, and some of the stuff's very different for us, so I'm excited.
What about any collaborations that we can
There may or may not be collaborations.
No, why would you do that? Any like anything that we need, like, you know, that's in the works, we can know a little
when
bit
you
about.
Find out what it is, you'll say, "Ah, oh, I wish he told us then." But we have to leave something to the imagination.
I mean, you could just like, you know, say, "Oh, we've got this cool video, but I won't tell you." However, we're collaborating with...
I'll just say one thing. Beyonce.
Such a liar. But that would be such a sick collaboration, right?
It would.
Is there anyone out there that you're kind of like, "Oh, we would love to work with that person"?
I mean, maybe Beyonce. But there's lots of people. We're like big fans of so many artists that we get asked this question a lot. And it's so hard because... we would be super psyched to work with so many different people. It basically comes down to like who really wants to work with us too, because there has to be like that mutual like synergy.
Is there anyone that you want to mention that you want to work with?
I mean, Quincy Jones would be pretty cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
It'll never happen, but
that would actually be awesome.
Yeah. I don't know.
That'd be sweet. I mean. That being said, just so any of the artists watching here, these guys are pretty cool and they're really nice and easy to work with. So, you know, Queen Bee, Quincy, hit them up, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Let's make it happen.
Yeah. With music comes fashion. Tell me about your fashion sense.
Well, when we perform, I like to wear amazing jackets and mm-hmm. stuff. And I've amassed a pretty large collection. I probably have like about 100 or so different jackets and kimonos and stuff. And I sort of dress the whole band and stuff that I own. And it's just like, I don't know. I always, since the beginning, thought it was important for like our visual representation to sort of match the music. And it's just like what I feel comfortable in when I'm on stage. As you can see, I'm like, you know, not wearing a kimono right now, but I try to be interesting in real life as well.
If there's any other country that you could probably live in and sort of be inspired by to write more music, where would that be? If you could be somewhere global.
People tell me all the time that I would love Japan, and I've never been to Asia at all. So that's what's coming to mind for me.
You would get a whole collection of kimonos.
Yeah, I'd probably go broke really quick.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah. What about you, Luke?
Oh, I don't know. That's a really good question. Sweden, maybe?
Nice. Why?
Just because there's so much really good pop music that comes out of there. You know, yeah. Like Max Martin, obviously, and like ABBA. I don't know.
I mean, I'm a big fan of ABBA, so that's fine. Is there anything you want to say to your fans? Because obviously, you guys are killing it online. Absolutely killing it. People love you. So what do you want to say to the guys out there?
Just that we love you too. And can't wait to get back out on the road and see you all.
Same.
And thank you for, we say thank you a lot, but we really do mean it, that we're grateful for our fans and, you know, whenever a song comes out, people listen to it and, you know, it never gets lost on us how cool that is. So we definitely appreciate it.
I like it. Well, boys, it's been an absolute pleasure. And I can't wait to see the video for Touch, which hopefully we'll see right now. Yeah, should we move on to the Touch video?
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah. And here's Touch.
It's so hard to trust, numb to all the feeling. My heart starts to rust, but I still know it's beating.